All right. Did you see it? I know you saw it. Millions of us saw it. Yes. Biden, once again, freezing up. Okay. How many times has this happened so far? All right. And here, as of late, it's happening quite a bit now. I think this is, the third time here in the past couple weeks. Okay. Basically wandering off, appearing lost, like in a dead stare and a gaze. All right. The media won't say it. And you know, doctors won't come out and say it. Anybody that's supporting. But look, people, okay. This thing here, seriously, it is unbelievably annoying. It is unbelievably annoying to me for the simple fact that any of us that have ever dealt with dementia. Now, I'm saying this based on experience. Okay. And I'm talking about any of us that have dealt with a close family member that you saw every single day, you grew up with, I mean, for years and years until they passed away. If they passed away from dementia, then you know exactly what it looks like from start to finish. Okay. I say this, as I said, from experience, because my grandmother passed from dementia. All right. And I saw it from start to finish, all the way through, and how it progressed. Now, there's no cure for it, as we know. All right. There are some ways to kind of slow it down a little bit, but it still progresses, and there's nothing you can do to stop it. So, as I said, if you have a grandmother, mother, father, anything like that, anybody close, aunt, uncle, anybody that you grew up with close, that you saw every day, you know what it looks like. All right. And again, you can't deny it. You can't deny it. Now, state media, they'll deny it all day long. They've been denying about this man for the past 4 years. Even matter of fact, there were signs of it before he even got into 1600 Pennsylvania, but didn't call it out then. If you can see Biden back 4 years ago to what he's progressed 4 years later, there is no doubt, no doubt. Yes, this man has dementia. Now, don't get me wrong. There are different levels of dementia. There are different levels of it, different stages of it, and how it progresses. All right. It is. I know this. And I'm not saying as a medical doctor, like I said, I'm not saying this as giving you medical advice or a medical professional on this. I'm just saying from my own experience watching this. Okay. I'm my grandmother's firstborn here. This woman helped raise me. Okay. Every day of her life. And like I said, I saw my grandma all the way till she passed away. And I knew what she passed away from, natural causes. I think she was 88. Natural causes, though. And big part of her natural cause was dementia. And that's exactly what it was stated as she passed on. It was dementia. Okay. It's horrible, man. It sucks. It's like Alzheimer's. It sucks. And there's nothing you can do to stop it. This man here, he definitely has it. I'm saying it. I'm going to put it out there and say it. Nobody else will say it. I know what it looks like. I'm not a fool. Okay. This is not just my grandmother, too. I got other family members that also passed from it, too, who had touches of it. Not as bad, but they had touches of it, too. Same thing. My grandma used to do the same thing. Some of the stuff that Joe Biden's doing, man, my grandma did the same thing in the early stages of it when she had it. You know what? Let me get the state media here. Because I ranted about this thing enough here. I'm going on 4 minutes into this. I just had to get this off my chest, man. I had to, because it's just eating me up. It pisses me off so bad that everybody's so scared to come out of it, because our commander-in-chief has this crap, man, and this is the leader of the freest world and the freest country in the world. And they sure as hell are running cover for him, and they will not call it out, knowing damn good well, yes, this man has it. But let me get to it. Let me show you exactly what I'm talking about here from CNN, state media, how they're trying to run cover on this so bad. And I don't know the guests that they got on here. It's just something I look and going through my news feed and everything like that. And it's just I had to say something about this, though, man. But watch this.
Barack Obama's camp firing back after widespread claims on the right that he needed to lead President Biden off stage after Biden appeared to freeze up at the end of a weekend fundraiser in L.A. So Eric Schultz is a senior Obama advisor, and he has put out a statement saying, quote, this did not happen. Now, this is in response to a tweet by the New York Post, which is pushing the claim of Biden freezing up. So here is the video that the Post linked to in its article that many have seized on.
Let's count how many seconds. Seconds frozen, staring, okay? Anybody else, like, I don't know about you, but Obama's waving, Jimmy Kimmel's waving, anything else? I know it's right at the end of the event here. Biden waves for a minute, stops, and then he freezes. Like, most people naturally would either start walking off stage, getting ready to go, knowing what to do. You're at the end here. You would either be still clapping, waving, and naturally just glance over and see if you and Obama exiting off the stage together or something like that. You would be glancing over at your boy over here to the side, you know, taking a quick peek or something, seeing he's getting ready to go. You wave, you look at Obama, you know, let's take off. You ready? All right, let's walk off. No, bro, 7 seconds standing there. What does he do? Barack grabs his wrist, gets his attention, turns him this way, walks him all hand on his back here. Basically, in general, everything short of what Biden's wife, Jill, does to him. I'm sure every single time when you see them together, when they're out, whatever, on some foreign trip, some deal, dealing with other world leaders here who are absolutely laughing their asses off at this dude at this point, 4 years in. They know this man is weak in dementia. He is gone upstairs, okay? He ain't making decisions. He ain't been making decisions ever since he got in. We know this by now. But 7 seconds froze. You're trying to tell me that my eyes didn't see this. This is what state media is trying to tell you.
All right, now there are still questions about what exactly happened there, but that clip comes just days after the far right used selectively edited video to claim that Biden was wandering off like some dementia patient from other world leaders during the G7.
Oh, I'm a freezer. She's sitting here trying to talk about as far as far right picking this out here with this video and trying to say that he walked off like a dementia patient. Yeah, he does have dementia, okay? First of all, everybody is standing here with, you know, this communist clown here, Justin Trudeau. Just north of the border here from where I'm at. Jesus. Anyway, between that, the Italian leader here, who else is back? I don't know these other players back here. Everybody is standing here getting ready for a photo op at this point, okay? Biden should know this. The cameraman is out of camera shot here in the video, but this is the reason why they're standing here. Watch. They'll have to adjust and everybody move over here in a second to get Biden's attention, get him back in this thing.
So I want to show you the video that they use to push that narrative. And it looks like, right, he's now, you see, okay, like staring off, looks bad, right? Well, when you extend it a little bit longer and it's unedited, you see a different story. You see that Biden briefly turned away and walked over, not to the middle of nowhere, but to give a thumbs up to several parachutists.
Okay, yeah, I get that. I saw the whole video of that myself, too, and I understand where they tried to edit the video and cut this out and say that he just walked all meandered out of shot looking at nothing. No, I saw the whole video. Here's my thing, too. Just because of simple fact, the man turned around, winding off, giving a thumbs up. The two parachutists are here, not paying attention to what's going on in front of his face, getting ready for a photo op here. Okay? The parachutists there that you're congratulating, they can wait after you get the photos done. Then you can turn around and then give them, congratulate them on a job well done or whatever they did, okay? That's normally how people do this thing. It's normally how it works, okay? Pay attention to the task at hand right now. You're standing with all the other leaders here, like, okay, and you see the cameraman sitting right there waiting to take a photo. That's why they're all grouped there looking that direction to take a photo op, okay? Biden meanders off. Pay attention here, Grandpa.
So that you actually see them there, along with a parachute rigger who is kneeling on the ground. So he wasn't just wandering off, right? He was interacting with somebody. So let's go straight to Arlette Sines at the White House. Arlette, I want to note you were there at that fundraiser where we just showed the video of former President Obama and President Biden together on stage. So, and I know it was a packed room. It was all kinds of celebrities, raised nearly $30 million. What can you tell us about, you know, what happened and what the White House is saying happened that night?
Well, Aaron, this moment came at the end of the fundraiser as the conversation between President Biden, President Obama, Jimmy Kimmel was ending. All three men stood up. The music came up in the room, and they went around the stage waving, giving thumbs up. And President Biden looked out at the crowd for a few seconds.
Sorry, sweetheart. A few seconds would be three. The man stood there for seven, froze.
Before walking off the stage with former President Barack Obama. Now,
after Obama grabbed his wrist to get his attention and help guide him off the stage.
There have been Republicans and right-leaning media outlets who have used this moment to say that President Biden froze and that he had to be led off the stage by President Obama. That is something that the White House and also Obama allies have been pushing very hard back against since this video was released. As you mentioned, one of President Obama's former advisors, Eric Schultz, tweeted that this did not happen.
Yeah, okay. My eyes are lying to me. The video footage is out there. Okay, we've all seen it. But my eyes are lying to me, just like yours. You know, you didn't see what you just saw.
Andrew Bates, a spokesperson here at the White House, said in a post on X, quote, by pretending the president taking in an applauding crowd for a few seconds is somehow wrong. All they're really admitting is, once again, is they can't take on the leadership that's fueling the strongest economic growth in the world and bringing violent crime to a 50-year low.
Okay, stop the BS, dude. Stop the BS. Please stop. Please stop the propaganda, okay? Bringing violent crime to a 50-year low. Okay? You sure about that 50-year low? Because I can bring this up for you, okay? I can bring it up. Let's see this here. FBI releases its crime report for 2021, but it tells us less about the overall state of crime in the U.S. than ever. Exactly. Okay, this is a report after 2021. This is also somehow, I guess they seem to miss the, 2020, 2021 riots. I believe it was just those 2 years of BLM and Antifa. You know, I guess they just skipped over that, didn't add that into the fact of the violent crime, which was responsible for over $2 billion worth of damage. Oh, yeah, and almost two dozen deaths. Okay, but I guess they just kind of missed that, right? Just that small little stat. That went on for like 2 years. And also on top of that, with the report here, he's saying as far as here 2021, with a 50-year low is what he's trying to tell you. Okay. Trying. But that's really not true because a lot of these states, blue-led cities, Democrat-run cities here, they're not reporting crime. They haven't been. They haven't been reporting crime to the FBI so they can be logged into the database for 2 years. So here it is, 2024, it hasn't been done. They haven't been reporting that. Honestly, I just saw something in another article where it was at 2021 and 2022 starting, 2 years, starting in 2022, crime wasn't being reported. Some crimes weren't. Okay, and actually start adding it up. And this is across the country. So I don't know. Just call me crazy, though, but this is sometimes, you know, when you start looking into things, you know, a little bit more. I don't buy into the propaganda, especially them spewing this crap.
White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre, in the briefing today, when she was specifically asked about this, said that Obama and Biden are friends, and what you saw was that they were friends, and that you saw President Biden walking out with Obama with his arm around him. But it does come at a time when the White House has been pushing back on some of these types of videos and these narratives taking hold in many right-wing, right-leaning publications, I should say.
You know what? When they come out here on the left and they try to tout that Obama and Biden are friends, I'm not buying that either. Honestly, I don't think Obama likes Biden at all. Honestly, I think Obama can't stand Biden, to tell you the truth. And I mean that. I mean, I wish I could have found the video. I didn't have time to look this thing up because it would take me forever for a while to try to find a video, but you remember the when Obama came back here, I believe after Biden was in office here, what, a year or something like that? Yeah, like at the end of 2021, something like that. And Obama had some dinner, some deal like that, or special, it wasn't a special thing. It was something where Obama came back. He's back in the scene and everybody was just clamoring all over Obama. And then you seen Biden in the background just there trying to get Barack Obama's attention. Barack just basically just blew him off like he wasn't even standing there, you know. Here's a president of the United States trying to get Obama's attention. Nothing. Biden wind up walking off to somewhere into the room, just meandering off somewhere into the room like a lost puppy or something like that. It was pretty sad. It's really sad. Hopefully I could try to find that video.
You noted that video from the G7 last week. And today, White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre pushed back on some of these types of videos, saying that they are done in bad faith. And that is how the White House is responding to these types of videos this evening.
All right, Arlette, thank you very much. And David Ehrman and Jamal Simmons are now out front. I mean, the one at the G7 very clearly shows, when you extend it, that he was interacting with a parachutist on the ground. Extremely different than the way the clip had been cut before. But David Ehrman, the White House and President Obama are pushing back. Obama is saying no, that President Biden did not freeze, that they're friends, that this is not, did not happen the way that it is being portrayed. So what do you think? Is it time for people to stop selectively clipping videos and putting them out?
No, come on. So first, let's go back to the G7, right? So the rest of the G7 leaders are getting, they're standing there, they're all kind of hanging out together. They clearly know there's a photo going to be taken, or they know their schedule, what's going to happen next.
Yep.
And apparently the president forgot what's going to happen next. Look, I know he turned around. He went over.
Well, maybe he just wanted to interact with the parachutist who was flying into the ground. I mean, you know,
well,
I can see it.
You know what? Listen, Aaron, maybe he did, but why? The rest of the G7 leaders
didn't.
The prime minister of Italy went over and grabbed him and pulled him back in. I mean, clearly there was something going on there. Look, you see it right. Watch it again. I mean, he goes over. Everyone else is standing waiting for a photo. He kind of wanders off. And they're like,
until the parachutist.
Whoa. You see that, right? You saw that. She was clearly over there by and right in front of Justin Trudeau, way over to the left. She walked across all of them right here just to go get this man's attention. Like I said, pay attention to the task at hand right now. Why did you forget? You just didn't notice the cameraman sitting out there in front of you, staring at you with a camera, trying to get a picture? Is that just what? You can't wait 5 seconds, you know, to even get a photo op or something like that, then turn around and congratulate these guys? Come on now.
They're trying to cover for them. They're trying to move. The whole group kind of moves with them.
Right.
And she's like, look, we got to take this picture. The video that you just showed with President Obama, I don't know how more clearly it can be demonstrated. That is not doctored. It is not selectively edited. He was standing there for whatever reason. Maybe he was taken in the crowd. I don't know. I'm not saying he froze. I am not saying that. All I'm saying is that former President Obama went back, took his hand, didn't put his arm around him like, hey, Joe. He took his hand like I would take my elderly father's hand and say, come on, Dad, time to go. Right?
Okay. That's not what happened.
This is where, honestly, I cannot stand suck ass shills for somebody. I can't stand it. I can't stand it, dude. It just irritates me, man. It frustrates me so much when people clearly, you saw the video, you watched it just like everybody else, and you still come out and try to gaslight somebody saying that didn't happen. It's like, we just saw Obama grab the man's wrist to get his damn attention, pull him a little bit there, pull his arm, and help guide him off the stage, okay? We just saw that, to walk him off the stage. What do you need to do that for, okay? He's a grown man. He should know what's going on next here after he was standing still frozen there for 7 seconds. So, man, I can't stand, I don't know, but him. Juan Williams, that's another one that it just absolutely annoys the hell out of me. It's just complete boot-licking shills, man. They just can't call it out when they see it right in front of their face. And that's not what happened. You saw it.
So listen, first of all, let's just gather ourselves here.
Gather your lies.
The President of the United States' body moves a little slower, but his mind is just as quick as ever.
Right? Is it really? Is it really? How many times we heard Biden bumble over a damn thing? He just did it. He just did it. What was it? Was it today? Yesterday? By the time you guys sit this video, by the time I get it posted up, man, it might be a day or so. It takes me a minute to get it up. We just saw him bumble over something here. I mean, he does it constantly, nonstop. That's a sharp mind, right?
What we saw happen when he was in Europe, and keep in mind, this is a man who's been to Europe 2 times Whoa. Over the course of 10 days, Whoa. Went to Los Angeles, sat on stage, and had 40 minutes of conversation with two other people for the entire audience to watch Damn. Before this moment that it is that you're talking about.
Wow,
my understanding is people in the audience were shouting and yelling at him. He's taking things in. The president comes over by hey. Obama, touches him on the hand, actually, lets him go.
Don't lie. Don't lie. Don't lie, dude. Come on, dog. Don't lie. He grabbed his damn wrist. We just watched the video. He grabbed his wrist, picked it up, tugged it just a little bit, get his damn attention, turn him around to drag his ass off stage. You just saw it just like we did.
They walk away. Then he puts his arm around him as they walk off. Watch it again, and you'll see it. He did not hold him by the hand the way you would hold a child.
David, that's can just I, you know, to this say point, David, can I just say, you know, I was with him at a town hall a few years ago. I was with him a few weeks ago at an interview. And then afterwards, he stays around. He talks to people and interacts with them until basically he's forced to leave. Is it possible, David, that this is just who he is? Yes, he's older. Yes, he moves slower. There's no question about that. But he's just, he wants to talk to someone. And until someone comes and pulls him away, he's going to continue the conversation.
Aaron, your viewers probably don't recall this, but I was Senator Arlen Specter's chief of staff. My former boss, Arlen Specter, and Joe Biden were very close friends. I used to ride the Acela from Washington, D.C. to Wilmington, Delaware with Joe Biden. I could tell you, President Biden likes to talk. I guarantee you that. I know that firsthand.
Mm-hmm. Damn right he likes to talk. He likes to brag, too. Loves to run his mouth. Just like when he ran his mouth about that quid pro quo there in Ukraine. Go back and see that video. He likes to run his mouth.
Okay, but I can also tell you that President Biden is a different person than he was then and a different person than he was 4 years ago. Look, it's natural. Father Time is undefeated. Absolutely. It's all our fates. You're going to slow down. And Jamal, listen, I hope he can do all those things because he is running to be the leader of the free world, the most important job in the world. So I hope he's up to it. I hope he can get on planes and fly. That's the job requirement. If he can't do it, he shouldn't apply.
Well, look, we're That's in right. about
because Trump is doing it, been doing it. And the man is, I don't know where he gets that energy. I don't know where he gets it from, but he does it and he don't have a problem. He don't have a problem walking. He can don't have a problem paying attention to what's going on to the task at hand. That's for damn sure.
10 days or so, 8 days. We're going to see that right here on CNN, right? We're going to have a debate. Where we're going to see the President of the United States stand on stage and have to do it the same way he did it at the State of the Union.
Nah.
Wait. Address.
No. Sorry about that. Sorry, I didn't mean to hit that quick. No. Sorry. He's not. The same way he did at Student Union, State of the Union address. No. Okay. I don't know what you had him hopped up on then at that State of the Union address or whatever, but he might be juiced up on something. Because after this fiasco here the past week of what's been going on with him and actually the past 2-3 weeks of crap, we're waiting to see this State of the Union. I will be tuned into this, or not State of the Union, but this debate with Donald Trump. I will be tuned into that one to see this. I think a lot of us are going to be tuned in to see this. Because I'm telling you, if the man has, if he has another freeze and if he has a Mitch McConnell moment, it's a wrap. It's a wrap. It's done. It's over. That's what we're waiting to see. If he has a moment like that, or he has a moment where he's seriously stumbling over his words or anything else of what he's trying to say, loses train of thought again, it's done, man. It's done. I don't care what you say at that point. It doesn't matter. Don't matter. Of course, state media right here, you know, they'll do everything to run. Carroll's one of the best debates that he's had yet. You know, he really showed Donald Trump. Yeah, I ain't buying none of that, man. I'm a tune in, just like you and me. If you all watch this, we are going to tune in because I want to see exactly what's going to happen to old Sleepy Joe. I want to see this with my own eyes. I'm just saying. He has one more. If he has one more episode where he meanders off, loses train of thought, or he freezes there in this debate. And this dude, it's done. It's a wrap. They will be trying to figure out a way, as far as the Democrat Party is going to try to figure out a way to move JoJo aside. Okay. They are going to desperately try to find a way to move him aside. We're just waiting to see.
So remember, what we're hiring here, well, we're hiring for different. President. Hold on one second, David. What we're hiring here is we're hiring judgment. And what you're trying to argue is that because his body is slower, that his judgment is not sound. I would say that's not true. Meanwhile, we have Donald Trump, who claimed his judgment was sound in 2020, who told Bob Woodward that he did not tell Americans how bad COVID was going to be because of the politics, that he did not let for three months have briefings about COVID because of the politics. And then in August 2020, did not weaken the standards for testing because he didn't want the testing numbers to go high because of politics. That's bad judgment. And that's the reason why we need to pick Joe Biden again.
Freeze. That was not bad judgment, because at the entire time when Trump was going through this thing with the federal, with his staff and everything, his administration, he was also taking advice from Fauci on this crap. Okay. You notice how he leaves out the context of exactly what went on in 2020. Hey, Chief, I was there. I was watching. All right. The whole damn time. When he's getting advised from Birx, from Dr. Birx and Fauci on this whole deal, everything he just spit out, he's saying, Donald Trump, this is bad judgment. Donald Trump had no idea what was going on at the time, just like anybody else who's sitting here now trying to play Monday morning quarterback over this crap. You know, damn good and well, Fauci and Birx was advising him on this deal, what was going on with COVID in 2020. Know that, all right? So save your BS, dude. Save it. Okay, because I'm not buying that either. I'm telling you, these, oh my God, they are so frustrating. They are so frustrating. The propaganda, man, the propaganda is just sickening that comes out of these clowns.
Again, because he's somebody concerned about the people, but Donald Trump seems to only be concerned about himself.
Another talking point. Yeah, that's it. That was only like about an 8-minute video or something like that. But yeah, that's a unbelievable point that this dude, man, like I said, we see this crap nonstop. It's every damn day. I swear to God, the media, they are seriously trying to run cover for Joe. And it's like, you can't run cover for this dude anymore. Okay. You can try like hell, but we're not stupid. We're not stupid. You got Karine Jean-Pierre coming out trying to talk about, these are just cheap fakes now. Cheap fakes. Really? We just saw the crap on TV. We're just watching it live and seeing this crap going on. It's on video. This ain't a cheap fake. My eyes ain't lying to me. I know what I'm looking at. We can all find all the full video footage of certain stuff, man. When you're talking about when you turned around in the parachuters right there, we saw the one cut, and I saw one cut of it. Then I saw the other video. I saw the longer video where he was sitting there giving a thumbs up to parachuters, but that's not the point. The point is the man turned around and meandered off trying to congratulate somebody here with the parachuter behind him here and not paying attention to what's going on in front of him. Dude, you're trying to take a photo op, man. Pay attention, Grandpa. You see the cameraman's right there. You see the group leaders. You're all standing together in a group. You had the leader of Italy. I don't know that lady's name. I know she's what, the prime minister, whatever she's in. She's right in front of Justin Trudeau. I know him. Castro's kid. But she walks completely from the left all the way to the other side of the group. And she walks all the way across everybody else and meanders over and grabs him, gets his attention. Hey, Grandpa, come back over here, man. We're trying to get a photo down here. But my eyes didn't see that. My eyes are lying to me. Okay. Stay focused. A man can't stay focused. He can't stay focused for what? Unless he's like freezing up. We already saw, what was that? That the gathering, what was it, that, I don't know if it's the Juneteenth crap, man. I don't even celebrate Juneteenth. I think it's a damn joke. If you want to celebrate it, it shouldn't be a damn national holiday. It should be something for Texas, because that's what it involves anyway. So, but, you know, everybody out there clapping. This was just last week, okay? Clapping, singing, dancing, you know, everything else like that. Biden is just standing there just like, he's sitting there like a 5-year-old just stunned. We saw that look. Just standing there. Nothing. Not into it. Yeah, I mean, at least clap. I mean, that's the least you could do. You at least try to clap with the beat. Show you got a little life in you or something. Good Lord. I ain't saying you got to sit out there and break dance or nothing like that. But God, man, do something, dog. Let everybody know you're awake. Something like that. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my God, man. This is unbelievable. It's getting to the point now it's low-hanging fruit. So this is going to keep going on. I'm telling you. Like I said, I'm going to be tuned in for that debate, man. I am. I want to see with my own eyes what the hell's going to happen. And they put everything in the favor of Joe Biden. Everything is in his favor. Cut the mics in between. Give them a couple breaks or whatever like that. No audience. Come on, man. I'm telling you. Like I said, if he freezes, it's it. It's over. You got everything in your favor for this debate, Biden. Everything in your favor that you wanted. You screw this up, dude. It's done. One slip is done. God, I can't wait. I'm praying for it. Please have a Mitch McConnell moment. Please. Just right in the middle of the sentence, man. Just, oh, God, I'm serious. I'm praying for it. I am. It's how much I don't like this clown. But anyway, let me know what you're thinking in the comments below, guys. You know, if you like the video, man, you know what to do. Yada, yada, man, enough. I will see you on the next one.